our half English part with our special guest, Kaan Bund from Turkey, employee branding specialist. Hi, Kaan, I'm really glad to see you.
Hi, glad to be finally part of the conversation, Anna.
Yes. Okay. Our topic now, we will continue with gamification and esport. As you might know, the latest development in gamification and esport are widely used by the leading companies such as McDonald's, Deloitte, Citibank, Rostelecom, Avon, and so on. Would you like to use it? They would like to be seen by young tech talent as a great place to work with challenging tasks and even as an employer which encourages not only hobbies but other interests and companies which don't use it yet really miss excellent opportunities to develop their employer brand tasks and ever as a employer that encourage employee engagement and team building. Also better candidates attraction, improving application and onboarding. Let me share one of my favorite examples, gamification in recruitment from Google. Google Code Jam. That's a series of coding skills tests. It's very interesting. There are multiple rounds of algorithmics of coding puzzle. For the title of Code Jam Champs and $15,000 who succeed in the competition I typically offer jobs in Google. Gamification and esport nowadays encourage team building, work satisfaction, and engagement. What staff feel like that's achieving something, even if it's a small task in gamification, they feel more satisfied with their job in the workplace. According to talent survey from 2019, over 80% of employees would like to engage in gamification. And 89% employees mentioned they are more productive with gamification in their workplace. Similar results can be found in Brand Resource, our open survey in IT companies. You can see it in our presentation. In IT clients 2020 and 2021, 73% of employees to 86% of employees are interested in esports. And from 76% to almost 94% of employees would like to participate in esports tournaments. Brand Resource now offers new services. We organize research and implement esport activities as a part of employer branding strategies and corporate culture with our esports partner ClickStorm. There's a global esport tournament coming up in November 2021. You will see update on our website. Also, ClickStorm showed that soft skills and team building can be boosted by gamification and esports. There's a good example from team building, the case of telecom provided, Yer Telecom company. With 1,050 and more employees were involved in 70-day game event. Nowadays, esports and gamification has a digital vibe and it's usually very much welcome in tech companies. Companies that want to be an innovative employer need to add gamification and sport in their employer brand strategy and corporate culture. I would like to share cases from Deloitte and McDonald's. McDonald's branch becomes an esports playground. With the goal of employer branding, McDonald's becomes more interesting for gaming fans, this target audience, as a particular team-oriented employer. So when team members go well together, you win not only one of the most famous esports disciplines, for example, Dota 2, but also in your job. Case Deloitte. It's interesting too because Deloitte launched the game I Want to Work for Deloitte to attract complement consultants for each segment of this audience. They develop their own activities. Only after employee completes, all level applicants are open. By the way, gaming experience, it's not required. Everything is very easy. Anyone can pass the test, but only players with really good knowledge and experience in consulting area received a bigger score. The quests are based on real Deloitte activities, but they are set in functional location. It's an interesting place, a token shop, a spaceship factory, the bottom of a gold mine. Many companies now are ready to take their creative messages to new target audience. They are looking for new opportunities for it. With and brand resource help them research, find original solution, and put there in a business life. We are open to innovation and unique projects to promote the employer brand. Why do we need creative production to attract candidates? Because advertising is everywhere. It has become more than marketing tools. We need to really looking for new opportunities and new ways. And advertising campaign is based on certain philosophy companies. The best of this philosophy is the idea. And the skeleton is a creative concept. What the behind this term? And how do you develop a creative conception for your brand? A creative concept is a unique idea in your communication between your brand and your target audience. Marketing advertising is based on a creative concept. It's positioned the brand and forms your employer branding. I think it's the main idea, and we need to focus on creative production too for attracting candidates. Khan, it is my short performance, and I think that you can share your cases and your unique examples from Turkey. Could you share it, please?
Thanks for setting the ground, Anna. By the way, let me introduce myself a little bit first.
Yes, yes.
So I provide both the strategies and the team management and project management at our employer brand agency. We are 13 years old, and we manage everything concerning employer brand management, like setting up the employer brand from scratch, including the employee value proposition, internal communications, candidate attraction, digital media, and so on. So we also got to meet with Anna and the team at our employer brand summit events, which I coordinate. And today I will be talking about how to engage the young talent in order for you to enroll them at your own company. And the key to that is to make your employer brand be talked about by the young talent. So in my presentation, I will tell you how to do that. And actually, Anna's presentation and mine complete each other. As we operate at an agency, I will be going into more details about the execution part. But first, I will be providing some data about what we are doing. But first, an introduction about how I gained my experience. I have worked with more than 150 employer brands, including both national and international brands. You can see some of these at your screen. So I will be giving examples about the ones that you might have heard of in your country. So about today, I will first provide details about what we are doing and why we are doing it. I will be including data while doing that. And then I will tell you how we perceive what we do at the agency. And then I will be giving some examples from companies that you might heard of before. So let's first ask, why do we need to attract candidates with our employer brand so that we will be going step by step? So we know from international research and especially research in the United States that people tend to change jobs every 2 years. They do this because they either get a better title or better salary or both of them. And most HR professionals in global companies do not recommend people who have stayed at a company for more than 2 years because they don't think that it shows the person as a dynamic person. Everyone is looking for dynamic teammates, especially in my country too. So recruiters here might perceive someone who has worked at a company as 5 years that someone who is not prone to change or who is against change. By the way, I have links for all of these research. If you need additional info or want to learn more about them, I can share them later on. And also, top 10% of the candidates are often enrolled within 10 days. So this means that you have to be quick. You cannot always expect people to solve your personality tests or ability tests at the same time. So if you are known as a great brand, then you will come to the mind of your target audience and they wouldn't need to do any kind of research about you. So they, you are already their favorite. And once they say that I need a new job, they will be applying for you. So we are trying to construct a sustainable pipeline for you. Another data, 42% of the young talent choose an employer by their prestige. This also means that if a brand has a strong corporate or consumer brand, the young talent tends to choose them. But on the other hand, 63% of these young talent used to choose by prestige. So we do this kind of research every year. The results in C were performed by us at our agency. We always ask 3,000 to 4,000 young talent about their inclinations. So as you can see, 21 points have changed in a year, at least in Turkey. This also means that you always have to refresh your data because the expectations of your target audience might have changed without you knowing about it. Another result is that engaged employees are 59% less likely to seek out a new job in their first year. So as you remember, engaged was also the name of the presentation title, and I will be focused on that a little bit more in the upcoming slides. So if we bring all of these results together, what do we get? Even if you recruit people by prestige, you retain them with your culture, because they experience your culture and they need to feel like they belong to a place. They need to feel like they are in their own community. And what is culture? It's the whole of your people. Everyone from interns to your CEO, to all of your suppliers and more. It represents you as a culture. And another data, from Turkey, we asked people, why do you follow social media career pages of companies? And the highest results was that 55% of the young talent follow career pages to see the company culture. So they want to see it and they want to experience it. You need to show your culture. Another theoretical part of what we do is the AIDA model, because of course we manage employer brands and we communicate all aspects of it. But whatever kind of communication we do, it has to follow the AIDA model, which is more than a century old already, because this is how a person's brains work. And international employer brand research, like the ones done by Universum, also take this model as the core of their approach. It means this, if you want people to apply for you, which is the action part in yellow, first you have to be desired. And in order to be desired, people have to be interested in you. And to summarize, people cannot be interested in a company that they are not aware that exists. So as an agency, we take part in all of these steps. And these stages are reflected in the stages of employer brand management like this. In the first two steps, we help brands get noticed and become center of attention. And after they convene or engage with our brand, we turn that interest into desire so that it can be turned into action. And how do we do that? As Anna has mentioned in her presentation, we have to be unique in order to do that. If we are completely like other employers, then our target audience will choose the one with the strongest consumer brand. But we also want to provide some psychological aspects of working at our company, which is our culture. And how do we differentiate our brand with culture? We make our target audience go through unforgettable experiences. And let's say that the person has liked our company so much, he or she started or interning at our company. And in our agency, we added a fifth step for this in employer brand management. As you can see, it's not loyalty, because let's remember that people tend to change up every 2 years. But if someone changes jobs only for the salary, why not make that person feel great about us so that he or she can provide word of mouth about our company? That's the key for sustainable success. We want happy and engaged employees, so they talk good things about us. Now, let's go over the additional data that I have mentioned. These go with everything concerning employer brand management. In Turkey, we base all of our young talent communication consultancy on this. So, first, I've talked about the importance of culture. We have to reflect our business culture via our employees. Because as you can see, the highest result from the first question was that I want to know about the view of the company's employees before applying. And second is that we have to show our development opportunities. Let's remember that in only 1 year during the pandemic, corporate prestige decreased from 63% to 42%. Why? That 29 point went to development opportunities. So we have to showcase that we are a place where people can flourish and develop. And the focus of our today's subject, it's also very critical to have competitions or contests. Why? Because the young talent thinks that it shows how much a company values them. Because they are also aware that these are huge projects and not everyone has to do them. But if you do that, then they will think that, oh, they are like our own generation's culture. So it's very critical. And also here, you can replace competitions and contests with gaming and gamification. Because the key for that is that the young talent is able to showcase how great they are within the leaderboards. It's a shortcut for them to prove their own worth. And last but not least, this is a thing that most of the people miss. You need warmer interactions with managers. Because when we asked during the pandemic, How would you improve the online program or event that you took part in? The highest result was I need to have more development opportunities about my own department or projected future department. So bringing all of this together, let's remember that in the AIDA model, most companies have difficulties turning interest into desire. And how we do that? We make people experience our culture so that they also have some kind of feelings about us. I will explain more in detail in a few slides. And this is another very critical point. Once we asked, what would you do before applying? What do you research about applying for a company? And two out of three young talents says that I always ask my peers before applying. So they, if they have friends in their universities, they ask about the perception of that company. So word of mouth is the greatest weapon we have while communicating our employer brand. And people talk about things that make them feel things. If you don't make anyone feel anything, they will not be talking about you. And word of mouth is completely free and sustainable, and it expands in a geometrical manner. So it always increases its impact. You want to be talked about. And some last data about our current topic. These are the data from Talent LMS. So employees say gamification makes me feel more productive for 89%. So obviously, it is safe to say that it increases productivity. And 88% said gamification makes me happier at work. So obviously, there is something there. And 78% of the candidates and employees say that gamified recruitment makes employer more desirable. And I will be sharing examples about all of these in the upcoming slides. So about the experience, gamification and gaming has lots of aspects. But what are the most popular aspects that are being used in the industry right now? They asked the candidates and employees. So 79% of the target audience say that I encounter badges. I see badges in gamification. 59% says I encounter points. 56% say I encounter physical or psychological rewards. And 59% says I see leaderboards. So if you bring all of these orange results together, they actually complete each other. So it doesn't make sense to have a leaderboard without points. It doesn't make sense to have a leaderboard without rewards. And it is a great way to accumulate points with badges. And I will be also showing some examples about this too. So let's come to the how part. I will be sharing a quote from one of my most favorite people who used to help with the Black movements in the middle of last century, Maya Angelou. She said that people will forget what you said, people will forget what you did, but people will never forget how you made them feel. So go through your own soul too, and you will see that you remember feelings instead of events or what was being talked about there. Let's remember your friend meetings. You most probably don't remember what you had talked about, but you remember that it was a great day, it was a happy day. So this is what she means. So we make people have feelings by experiencing our culture. So the keyword for turning interest into desire in the AIDA model is the experience part. So what are the steps while designing this so-called experience, and what are the components of this experience keyword? First, we think like them while designing our user experience and user interface. These are the people who were born with telephones in their hands. So they are really dynamic. They don't want to even watch videos more than 59 seconds long. They don't even want to touch the screen to go to the Instagram Reels, for example. Just to give an example about this, if you are going to do a social media video, make sure that it's longer than 1 minute. they don't have the time for anything. So also, we always want young talent to prepare an elevator pitch for their ideas while making them work on case studies. But what is our elevator pitch as an employer? Do we have a persona? For example, if our company was a person, what that would look like? Would that be a person with a gray suit? Or would that be someone with shorts and a shirt? So create your own persona and make them talk to the young talent accordingly. And while doing that, of course, you will be using the same language as them. Don't look too corporate, but it also changes on your segmentation too. The IT talent wants to be talked differently than the one who is aiming for a career in human resources. So as I mentioned in my presentation's beginning, always do your research, just ask around or make use of student clubs or agencies like us so that they provide data. Thus, you can have KPIs about your success. Another critical point is to be always reachable, always up to answer the young talent's questions, because we said that our keyword is experience and you cannot make them experience anything without engaging them. So you have to engage them in all of the platforms, emails, social media, your career website, and more. And while doing all of these, make sure that you are consistent and simple. You don't want to look like a schizophrenic person. Consistency means this. If you say that you are a very digital company who is ahead in digitalization, do not provide anything with paper, or do not provide anything really difficult with lots of steps, who has a very bad user interface. So they will see that and think, no, this is not a company for me. And we do this because we do not want to look like my great friend Steve Buscemi here. Most of the brands mistake this. Let's say that persona of the employer is someone who is wearing a brown suit. But you cannot make that brown suit person talk very dynamic, colorful, and a fun manner. Then you will look like this as a persona. So I have talked about the beforehand part of creating an experience, but what does this keyword really include? So the experience part is the complete totality of your communications. That starts once your target audience encounters your ad and starts using your user interface. So the experience of your brand starts with the ads and user experience. Then your target audience will want to see if your content is aligned, if you are giving the same message everywhere, in every platform. So you should be talking in parallel in your both corporate website, your career website, at your gaming tournament, at the handout that you provide, and more. And I mentioned a few minutes ago that engaging your young talent is very critical. You have to be always there. Make sure that you communicate all of the time. And the next step is the assessment and or evaluation part. This is also a huge part of the candidate experience. You don't want to lose time, because remember, the top 10% that you want to hire are often lost from the market in 10 days. So you always got to be quick and you have to engage them to summarize the first 4 points. And now let's go into some detail. So handouts and or gifts and or prizes are very critical, because these are the details. Anyone can do the search first part. Anyone can reply a question. Anyone can start a career website. And anyone can organize a gamification contest or a gaming contest. The devil is in the details. So you want to create your handouts also in a great manner, because then they will think, wow, they went into so much detail. They really are thinking about us. So that is a great part of the experience, because what you are going to provide will be unexpected. And second, communication again, because as I mentioned, you have to be always communicating. That's why I repeat the communication part twice. And now let's get back to what Maya Angelou said. You want to create those memorable moments. You have to be unique. You have to show how you differ from other employer brands. Just to give an example out of the blue, let's say that you are holding a hackathon. So you need a clear mind for that hackathon. And why not have a morning yoga before starting the competition? So that's an additional value for your event. And then you will be remembered very fondly, and then they will be talking about your employer brand. They will be saying, wow, they thought it out so well. They even had a yoga event for us so that we have a clearer mind, for example. And adding value is also a huge part of employer brand attraction. And now it has the same value as your corporate prestige while the young talent chooses employers. You also have to have some development opportunities while showcasing your culture with your people. What I mean by this, before having a gaming tournament or a hackathon and ideathon, we always add some boot camps the day before or the few hours before the competition begins. Why and what? We provide data, we provide training for teamwork, we provide data for their projects, we provide some soft skill trainings like presentation, agile working or design thinking and more. And this adds value to them and it makes them feel great so that they remember us fondly and create word of mouth for their environment. Now, I'm going to speak about some of the examples in Turkey. But beforehand, I want to give a message. We should never forget that whatever the case may be, we always have to be hiring people for our companies. So it makes sense. It makes more sense to have online events as we have learned from the pandemic. I will be giving a case about it in the upcoming slides. But first, about a company that you might know of. This is the Coca-Cola bottling company founded in Turkey. They manage 13 countries from Turkey. So the case was that they approached us as an agency. And what they needed was to standardize all of their campus recruitment. And they wanted all of the departments in their company have the same process for recruitment because they all had various recruitment processes. But what great employer brands need to do is hire by culture. First culture, then technical skills. Technical skills can always be added, but the culture of a person is really difficult to change. So we need to hire the culture. And now let's talk about some numbers. In our first year, in our first project, we received 2,400 applicants and we more than doubled this number the next year because we created a huge word of mouth. And out of these applications, we received 1,700 for assessment processes. And after all of the tests and exams, we chose 100 candidates from there. And then we divided them into teams of three, and we had 10 teams. And of course, 10 person was substitute in case 10 people didn't show up. We had backups. And after this project, Coca-Cola İçecek hired 11 part-timers. And then 9 of these people turned into full-time employees. So you can say that we had great results in both quantity and quality. And our project was that with a team of sustainability, we had a gamified recruitment process. So remember the previous slides, that they had development opportunities before the event, and they also had a chance to prove themselves while having fun in a very short period of time. And also almost everyone in CCI, Coca-Cola İçecek, was there to observe the process. And they said that we had so warm interactions with our managers. And now let's see a video about that. It has English subtitles.
Merkezi saygısı. bayağı güzel karşılandık. Buradaki çalışanlarla tanıştık. Eğlenceliydi, aşırı eğlenceliydi. Hatta hayatımda ilk defa böyle mülakat
yaptım. Sana kadar geldiğim en organize mülakat olacak.
Sadece gerilmek yerine bayağı bir eğlendim. O yüzden güzel. Bu mülakatta her şey vardı.
Her şey vardı.
Please observe how excited and happy our target audience is. This is a very rare sight. So it is obvious that they talked about us in a very good manner with their peers. And that's how we doubled our application numbers. So I did not talk about what the game was on purpose because I wanted to pull everyone in. As you might imagine, it's an escape room game where a team has to solve puzzles. And the escape room had a sustainability team with like global warming, polar bears and more, because we have to be consistent with Coca-Cola's message. And now another example from a global company who is active in Turkey. Most of you probably have heard of Vodafone. So our case from them was that they wanted to increase their IT talent pool, and they especially wanted to attract women candidates because they are a very positive company about equality. And we had 1,350 applicants, and we also divided them into teams of three, and we had 14 teams. And the content of this gamification was that there is a digital assistant of Vodafone in Turkey called Toby. Yeah, you might see him on the right up corner. And the name of the event is Digital Pioneers, Toby Hack Edition in Turkish. So what they do, they try to hack the digital assistant and add new features to that assistant. And we worked in parallel with Microsoft. Microsoft has provided a user interface that makes it very easy to hack. And before starting our Digital Pioneers Toby Hack event, of course, we had an application process. And we had a very different assessment process for this project. We created a three-step knowledge quiz game, and we invited everyone from all of the universities. In the first stage, we asked about digitalization, like machine-to-machine, Industry 4.0, 5G, and more. So we want people in line with our culture. If you are always talking about digital, if you are always talking about future, then you want to work with employees who are also in line with the latest trends. That's why we asked about digitalization in the first step. And in the second step, we asked about Vodafone and their perception of overall employer brand. And the third step, as Vodafone is a global company, we need people who can speak English well. So while the first two tests were in Turkish, the last one was in English. And it was like a general ability test. Some math, some knowledge, and more. And we weeded out our 42 competitors from these applicants. And now I will be sharing some examples for the detail that create the experience. And another point about this project, we had started it just before COVID struck the world. We wanted to organize it in Vodafone Arena, which is a football stadium, But after COVID hit, we had to carry our project online, and we did, because as I mentioned before, whatever happens in the world, the wheels have to turn, and we always have to recruit people for our company. So it makes so much sense to have experience in organizing online events. In our experience list, in our experience components, I have talked about handouts, gifts, and prizes. Here are some of the examples of our goodie bag. So we had some sweatshirts, we had a hygiene kit because COVID had just struck, and we also provided a power bank and a notebook with USB in it. And also in that tote bag you see on the left side, it says snack kit. So another detail that we thought about and which received great feedback from our competitors was that these little note cards we had while handing out the gift bags. So they told us that it is so great that you think about us. We really do feel like you think about our well-being, they said. Because in the notes, we said, we know that your brain needs energy for this very difficult competition. So here are some snacks with high in energy. We also know that energy is very important for us. So we provided a power bank for you, so your phone's energy never runs out. And it was also very cold while we were holding this competition. That's why we handed some sweatshirts with hoodies so that they protect themselves. We also told them that you are very important for the digital innovation of our country. So you need to protect yourselves, and we want to be a part of it. I can go into more detail if you ask me via LinkedIn or from the chat window after my presentation. I'm not able to view any of the comments. And here is a very short video with some screenshots from our event. It's completely in Turkish, but you don't need to know about what people say. Just observe their feelings. It's a great thing that you don't know Turkish, because it's a huge part of turning interest into desire. As you can see, even the video itself is completely in line with Vodafone's messaging. That's what I meant by being consistent in your messages. I have shown you some gaming and gamified examples for talent attraction. I also have some examples for internal communications too. Now I will be showing them. These two brands, we work not so often. They are not really our customers, but they are some nice examples from my country. Turkcell is the biggest telecommunications provider in Turkey, and they are the first. So they attract lots of candidates due to their corporate brand. But of course, they also need to engage their employees. So they started a PUBG mobile tournament within the company after PUBG first arrived in Turkey. So that was a great opportunity, and they also provided awards from PUBG as prizes. And on the right-hand side, you can see a gamified visit to the campus of a bank. The bank is called Yapı Kredi. They also have a digital assistant, and they made use of the 360 cameras when they were first invented, and they provided a complete trip around their campus, around where they work, so that people would be able to experience their culture wherever they are and whatever they are doing. You just need a phone or a computer or a tablet in order to reach Yapı Kredi's culture. Another example is from the national telecommunications provider from Turkey. So I will give you a few seconds so that you can guess what these three things are. You have most probably seen things that look like this. These are the badges from a gamified process in Türk Telekom's internet communications. So Türk Telekom, the company that I have mentioned, has a program within called Mujit, which means inventor in English. And they want to receive project ideas or overall ideas from their own employees. And in order to increase engagement, in order to increase people who participate in this ideation process, we have started bringing in badges so that badges can be turned into points, points can be turned into rewards. And also you have a leaderboard, which is like a carrot for all of the employees to do better about them. And here on your screen, you can see an internal email about the results from that program. And about the badges, there are three steps of badges. For example, it says idea magician, idea machine, and idea colleague. You can see on the left side. And the more further in steps your badges are, the bigger points you get. So this had great impact within the company. So we applied this badge system to another project of Türk Telekom, which is called Türk Telekom Academy. This is where they provide online and offline development opportunities for all of the employees. And in order for employees to develop themselves more, we also added the badge system here too. You can see the screenshots from this email. The visual in the right top side shows you the leaderboard and also the badges. So we have increased the academy engagement more than 40% in just a few months. Another internal example is from a Turkish bank. It says, are you ready to be a part of huge excitement? So we had 9 different gaming contests. And also we have invited people or employees from other companies too, to make the tournament feel even bigger. I'm sure most of you already have heard of the games here. And it doesn't make sense to only hold a gaming tournament. You also have to keep it sustainable. And how do you make it sustainable? As we have mentioned in the talent LMS data, you also gotta have some points and you gotta have some rewards. And from the points, you can be a part of a reward program in this bank called Artı Değer. You can see in the middle about the launch announcement of it. And we also have a leaderboard for all of these competitions and games too. We also announce our leaderboards once in 2 months. And we also hand out rewards based on the company's values. You can see 5 different colors here. And all of these colors represent their values. So this is the last example, and I'm about to finish the presentation. This is called Digital Portal. This is about the digitalization of the complete registration process, and the left-hand side is the invitation. And here's a short video about our digital orientation process. And we had coverage in mass media and newspapers about this. So they can engage with all of the screens. They can see the values. They can see the benefits. They can get to know the departments. They get to know the campuses and more, because this is a company with over 10,000 employees. They also receive some knowledge about the development opportunities and more. This subtly is the end of my presentation. I have provided you some data, both international and national, and I've talked about the most critical part of holding gamification events or any kind of employer brands. It's the experience. You want to make people feel emotions so that they remember you well and they talk about you, and the word of mouth creates organic and sustainable attraction for your employer brand. And Anna, have you got anything to add before we go into the panel?
Khan, thank you. Unfortunately, we have a time limit, and we have some questions to you about your presentation from our participants. Hi, Khan. Question from Andrei. What difficult did you encounter while implementing the project for Coca-Cola?
It was designed only for the young talent, which in our country means university students in the third and fourth grades or fresh graduates. So that's a great question. Are you talking about only titles or age group? Do you have any idea?
Next question. The project was designed for only juniors only. How effective is the gamification to attract middle or seniors? It's my next question. We were talking more about how can we get together older generation? Yeah? How can we attract the boomers? It's our next question. Could you explain more about case for Coca-Cola? I think it's a interesting topic. Yeah.
So, of course, it makes sense to attract millennials with gamification. But as I mentioned in the beginning of my presentation, the key there is to be a leader or have a very short time so that you can prove your worth. So you wouldn't want to wait to solve 3 tests and 3 weeks in order to be assessed by a company. So this is the key part. But why do young talent like this? Because they are used to have everything happen very quickly. But older generations are not like this. So first, before engaging with middle or seniors, we have to take them the same level as the young generation. What I mean by that is this. Younger generation is very social than the previous generations, especially due to social media. They love to do everything as a team. But the older generations are more self-absorbed. They would like to work more personally. So first, we have to make them taste what achieving as a team feels like. So in order to do that, first, we need them to engage with younger generations within a company. And in our agency, we also design some programs for that too. For example, we offer cross-generational communication programs. And the reason why we do that is this. The boomers and millennials are speaking in really different languages. They don't understand each other. For example, in Turkey, no one likes to be called Mr. or Mrs. if they are young. But people above the age of 40 love to be called Mr. and Mrs. This seems like a very simple solution, but actually most people cannot even manage this. So first, we have to make them speak the same language so that we don't encounter any problems when we invite the boomers to gamification events. And after this soft skill development program, you need to have another internal program for both of the generations work together. For example, we had some internal ideathon and hackathon or case study competitions. We had a director and we had a fresh graduate, and then we teamed them up and they worked against similar teams, like with a manager and a specialist and stuff like that. So while doing that, they were also having fun because they were gaming. And you know how people's psychology work. If two people are working towards the same goal, then they get closer together. So once we create this experience, then they feel that, wow, it is great to win as a team. And I have so much to learn from young people too. They are not like what I imagined our older employees say after coming to our competition. So after doing this, the older people will be talking to other older people. The millennials will be talking to other millennials. And this word of mouth will be starting to transform the culture. So it will become a culture where older people are speaking about gaming. And there are some IT companies in Turkey, like Etia or Gidiyor, maybe you have heard of them. Now, even their general managers or sporting general managers join this competition too. Because it makes them feel relaxed. It makes them feel connected to the younger audition. Thus, they also make themselves feel young too. And they also measure the soft skills or talents of the young people, they say. So it's a great way to observe a personal culture for your employees too. I hope I was able to answer that. What do you think, Anna?
Great, great example. It's very interesting. Unfortunately, we have a limited time. Oh, I think we will organize something else together when we have more time. So to sum up, today we have seen the gamification. It's really great way to engage candidates at new hire. Sports and gamification promote employee engagement, boost productivity, increase engagement, help staff retain knowledge, set and meet key goals and benchmark. It's with a really fun way. I think it's really big opportunities to attract and retain talents with a different generation. Yeah, I absolutely agree with you about tech talents, more young talent, but it's really interesting way for and other generation too. But we need to know more about our target audience. And maybe do you have one question or short question for me? And unfortunately, we need to finish our conference. And I hope we will organize something else together. Okay.
Yeah, it was great fun. I wonder one thing about the Russian audience. For example, what is the greatest difficulty you encounter while holding employer brand contests or game tournaments? What is the most difficult thing?
The most difficult thing, I think, it's understand exactly what our target audience need and to organize something interesting with a fun way and to not forget about our metrics, our goals, what company really need. And we need to combine these both and to show the most important thing for our target audience, because we know that esports and gamification, it's innovative tools, it's good tools, but we need to focus on our business function or what we need to organize for company exactly. I think so.
Yeah, if you create a persona for your candidate and a persona for you as an employer, you imagine them as like two different people and you want to make them like each other. So it simplifies the process, in my opinion.
Exactly. Because it's more difficult, but it's more interesting. It's very challenging.
Since we have the same challenges in both countries.
Exactly. And would you like to know more about gamification and esports? Follow us on our social media. Maybe if you have some questions to Khan, send us please too. And we will discuss it one more time. And check your email for our updates. And thank you for joining our conference. And it was really great time for us with Khan too.
Yeah, it was great fun. And everyone can hit me up from LinkedIn. I'm up to answer your questions. Any kind of question you have, I will be more than glad to answer.
Just a second. One question. I'm planning to organize new webinars about gamification and esports. It's a very interesting topic, but it's now a very actual and developing at the moment. I think, we will prepare something else and maybe it will be more global and more time. Okay, that's all. Okay, if you will have some questions, to send us to email, please. Okay, thank you, Khan. Thank you, our participant. Okay, see you.
Yeah, thanks for listening, everyone. Take care.
Okay, thank you. Bye bye.